wife Colleen and I were invited to share this story of our ministry here in Bangalore, which is really Colleen's ministry. She's unwell and therefore she is not here, which is actually unfortunate because, as I've said many times, she practices and I preach on what she practices. And therefore, it is her ministry, a local ministry of North Bangalore, a journey in Christian holistic mission. I hope the PowerPoint will work well and will sync with what I'm saying. If it doesn't, I hope someone will kill it. In 1967, Colleen Phillips, a 20-year-old Bangalorean, entered into a deeper personal relationship with the Lord Jesus. She became a volunteer with the Home Missionary Society, an indigenous mission started by five women here in India in 1907. She assisted in a Saturday Bible club for children from economically poor families in Lingarajapuram, a shanty town outside the municipal limits of North Bangalore. The club met under a tamarind tree. In 1969, Colleen married Vinay Samuel, that's me, an assistant pastor of St. John's Church, Bangalore, an affluent middle-class suburb in a comfortable part of Bangalore. In 1974 to 75, Vinay returned to St. John's as a senior pastor, and Colleen resumed her ministry in Lingarajapuram that now had many families living in slum-like conditions. Two ministry efforts were initiated, a weekly Bible study with Christians who had moved into or near the area, and a tutoring program for working children to enable them to join regular schools. The Bible study group became a growing worshiping community, having built a community center in 1978. The work with children extended to mothers, families, and communities. Now that's Colleen a little older. She was still as pretty like that in 1969 when I married her. In 1983, Colleen and I, with our four children, moved to live in this slum area. And strangely enough, the same year, God also called me to start the Oxford Center of Mission Studies in Oxford, England. Two most dissimilar places you cannot imagine. And God wanted me to juxtapose the two together. Now I realize why, because some of you guys have went and got your PhDs there, including Doug Birdsong. Over the past 35 years, the ministry has covered over 12 communities, rural and urban, in North Bangalore district. It addresses educational needs through preschool programs, schools and adult education programs, health needs through community health programs, in a collaboration with state and civil society institutions, economic development needs through self-help groups, micro-enterprise financial services, SMEs as well, through our own Christian bank and a financial services center, vocational training, community building needs through advocacy organization, and facilitating supportive relationships between state institutions like the police and communities. At one point, Colleen became an honorary police officer and would often threaten me with arrest. If I crossed the line, but I never knew what the line was. So whether I never knew whether I crossed it or not. So meeting the needs of the most vulnerable with children's homes, shelters, and family support. The program serves several thousand families in need. Two motivations. Our ministry is driven by two motivations. Jesus' commission to his disciples after his resurrection is found in John 20:21. As the Father has sent me, I'm sending you. We took that to mean that as his disciples, we are called to reflect in our mission engagement both the manner and nature of Jesus' mission. Not only what would Jesus do, but also how would Jesus do it. Jesus' call to announce the good news is the second of the kingdom of God. Having been drawn into the kingdom by the Lord Jesus and enabled to experience its grace and power in our lives, we joyfully and sometimes fearfully accepted his call to reach out with the gospel to the most vulnerable, disadvantaged, and poor communities. Four movements. God's calling not only directed us, but also enabled us with a deep compassion. The Holy Spirit created in us a hunger to see that the righteousness of God's kingdom, the right relationships of justice and peace, became a reality among the people we were called to serve. The first movement is sit. Our journey began with sitting with the people we were called to serve, sitting on the floor with them. In these communities of the poor, relationships are based on differentiation in power and social status, real or perceived. The call to emulate Jesus meant that this has to be addressed first. When visiting the home of a poor family, you see the family produce a chair, possibly borrowed from a neighbor for you to sit, while they sit on the floor, so affirming the difference between them and us. By insisting gently on sitting on the floor with them, the difference is bridged, both symbolically and actually. Colleen did it very well. Vinay found it very hard to do. The relationship based on our common inheritance of being created in God's image, loved and valued by God equally, began to be built. Sit. See. As you sit and listen, you see what God is doing already in that community, much before you. God enables you to see what he wants you to see in the community. Its needs and its brokenness, its assets and its energy, its sin and the evil that stalks it, the hunger and the longing for change. Then share. You share your gifts and needs and enter into a family relationship to address the needs of the community. In that sharing, you partner in creating a community from shattered, fragmented, and battered communities, a covenant community. Work. You labor to make the kingdom known, sharing the good news of what Christ has done and engaging in ministries focused on transformation and integration. Transformation is to see change that is recognizably part of God's kingdom. There was often a tension between growth and transformation, as the focus on ensuring transformation in our ministry, transformational impact, often affected growth adversely. Integration is the unity of the spiritual, the social, and the material. This is above all the work of the Holy Spirit, seen in the emergence of believing and worshiping communities of Jesus' disciples. In our ministry, mostly, nearly all from non-Christian backgrounds, who are the core of our ministry. Through them, spiritual energy flows into all the work in the community, integrating heavenly and earthly life. As we keep praying, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. God's name be glorified. Amen.